be judges for the day today.
Right.
Yes.
So we are live now.
Sorry.
So we are in live only.
Be judges for the day today.
Right.
Shall I start now? Ma'am, so. Sir, shall we start now, sir?
Oh.
So, good afternoon, sir. Shall we start now?
Yeah, please. So, students are online, is it?
So, this is live streaming, sir, YouTube mein. So, they will join, sir.
Right. So, you can start, yeah.
Very good afternoon to one and all present here. It gives me immense pleasure to welcome you all to All India Online Physiology Festival 2020. Myself, Dr. Divya, postgraduate student in the Department of Physiology, Lady Harding Medical College. I would like to thank all the audience and participants for gracing this today's occasion with us. I request Dr. Sunita Mondal, ma'am, Head of Physiology Department, Lady Harding Medical College, and also the organizing chairperson of this festival, to say a few words. Ma'am.
Thank you, Dr. Divya.
Thank you.
A very good afternoon to all present today on this very special occasion of All India Online Physiology Festival 2020. On behalf of the whole team of Department of Physiology, Lady Harding Medical College, I, Dr. Sunita Mondal, head of the department, have a great pleasure in welcoming the students and faculties of various medical colleges from all over India. We are very proud to celebrate this festival for the first time on All India level. The idea of Physiology Festival was pitched to me for the first time by one of our faculty members, Dr. Madhulika Munga, this year. The main objective was to make physiology concepts a fun to learn by various and creative methods. We organized it at a small level with our second semester students. We were really amazed and overwhelmed to see their enthusiastic participation in this event. Even for us, it was a thoroughly entertaining plus learning experience. Who thought learning something serious can be fun too? Well, now we stand corrected. I invite all of you to be a part of our exuberant journey for the next 4 days. I welcome our patron, Director Sir Dr. N.N. Mathur. I welcome you, sir. I'm also really happy to welcome our distinguished guests who have consented amidst the tight schedule to judge and share every movement of this wonderful function with us. Dr. Mona Bedi, Director Professor, Department of Physiology, is joining us from Maulana Azad Medical College, New Delhi. I welcome you, ma'am. Dr. Tanmay Talukdar, Head, Department of TB and Chest Diseases, is joining us from our own Lady Harding Medical College. I welcome you, sir. Now, I request our director, sir, Dr. N.N. Mathur, to please bless us. Dr. Mathur, sir, please.
Thank you, Dr. Mondal, for inviting me today to this, the first event that I am attending, which is called the Physiology Festival. I never heard of it.
Students are online, is it?
This is live streaming, sir, YouTube
mein.
So they will join, sir.
Right. You can start, yeah.
So, am I online? All right. So, I never...
Very good afternoon to one and all present here. It gives me immense pleasure to welcome you all to All India Online Physiology Festival 2020.
Myself, Dr. Divya, postgraduate student in the Department of Physiology, Lady Harding Medical College. I would like to thank all the audience.
So please continue, sir. Thank you.
Yeah, there was some,
sorry for the disturbance.
There was some audio overlap.
Yes, sir. Sir, right. It's been taken care of. Please continue, sir.
Okay. Thank you very much. And thank you for inviting Dr. Mandal to this festival of physiology festival, which I'm told is attended by all the students from all over the country. It is the unique thing which is happening, and I have never witnessed such an activity before. And I'm sure this activity will take care of many gaps that are there in the teaching program, and will address that also. And at the same time, it will be an opportunity and a platform for all the students to interact with each other from all over the country, whosoever is the first year or the second year student all over the country. I wish such an platform existed in my time, and that too virtual, where I could meet each and every student, first year student all over the country. And what a wonderful opportunity it is to interact with amongst yourselves, and to know each other, whether you are sitting in Thiruvananthapuram, or you are in Srinagar, or you are in Delhi, or in Calcutta, or in Surat. That is amazing. And it's aptly being organized by the physiology department, because we remember from our college days that the very impressionable age it is when you enter the medical college. And you remember these days throughout your life, the first lecture in anatomy, or the your time spent in physiology, or your work done in the biochemistry lab. You never forget, because these are very impressionable age. It's a very impressionable age, and you have just entered the medical college, and everything is new. Thereafter, the memories are not that sharp, you know. They are there in your mind, but you do not remember them all throughout your life. But you always remember your time spent in the first professional examination, and where you spent, and who were your teachers, and who were your peer group, and what did you do there. So it's very important that this cohesiveness, which can be taken care of amongst the students by the activities like the festival, are very, very important. And especially during the COVID times, when you physically cannot move around and interact with the students all over the country, it is even more important. So I'm sure you will enjoy all the activities in this festival, and I'm told it is charged with a very vibrant program for 2 days. And all the best to the students, and all the best to the faculty who are coordinating this event. Thank you very much. All the best.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for sharing your thoughts and for engaging us to organizing this festival. I request Dr. Madhulika Monga, Professor in Physiology Department, Lady Harding Medical College, and also the organizing secretary of this festival, to join us on this platform. Madhulika, please.
Thank you, Divya. Good afternoon, all. First of all, I, Dr. Madhulika Monga, would like to thank one and all for supporting this unique first-time attempt of ours to link physiology to creativity. We are truly overwhelmed by the support of our seniors and fellow physiologists across India, who not only encouraged and supported us, but also encouraged their students to participate with great enthusiasm. Thank you so much on behalf of our team. As our respected head of the department, Dr. Mandal, said, that the idea of the festival is to bring creativity into physiology so as to make learning physiology a fun thing. Albert Einstein said, and I quote, "Creativity is intelligence having fun," I unquote. And so I believe that today all of us here would have fun watching our young undergraduates pour in their intelligence in the most creative way of drama or skit. The participants have already submitted their respective entries in the form of a video, which would be streamed one after the other. The time limit for each video is 5 minutes. We have 3 prizes for the skit, first, second, and third, which would be decided by our judges for the day. We also have an audience choice award. The link of the same has been shared in the description box. The voting link has been opened and it will be closed within 30 minutes of the end of the screening of the last entry. The announcement of the prizes for all the categories would be announced together on the last day, that is 10th December of our festival. So let me introduce you all to our esteemed judges of the day. It gives me great pleasure to welcome Dr. Tanmay Talukdar. Dr. Tanmay Talukdar is professor and head of department, Department of Tuberculosis and Respiratory Medicine at LHMC. He has a long clinical and teaching experience of 18 years. He has done his undergraduate from UCMS, Delhi, and post-graduation from Vallabhbhai Patel Chest Institute, Delhi. He started his academic career as an assistant professor in Jipmer, Pondicherry, where he served for 4 years before joining our institute in 2010. He is also the recipient of the Young Scientist Award for the National College of Chest Physicians, which he received in the year 2001. He has many publications to his credit and has organized many seminars and conferences. He holds many more responsibilities, and to list a few of them, he is the chairman, Operational Research Committee of Delhi State for the revised National Tuberculosis Control Program. Chairman, District Drug Resistant TB Committee, Revised National Tuberculosis Control Program of New Delhi District. He is the nodal officer of Tobacco Free Initiative of our institute, the convener of Students Leadership Mission of our institute, and a very active resource person of Medical Education Unit of Lady Harding Medical College, our institute. Above all this, Dr. Tanmay himself is a very talented orator, debater, and actor, and I've had the pleasure of having witnessed his skills as an actor during the various medical education workshops that we have conducted. I heartily welcome you, Dr. Tanmay. Thank you for joining us today.
Thank you, Dr. Madhulika, for inviting me. Thank you so much.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Madhulika. I'm Dr. Anita Pawar, Professor, Department of Physiology, Lady Harding Medical College, and it gives me an immense pleasure to welcome Dr. Mona Vedi, Director Professor, Department of Physiology, Maulana Azad Medical College, as our second judge. Ma'am is an undergraduate from Lady Harding Medical College, and she's done her post-graduation from Maulana Azad Medical College in 1998. She has joined MAMC as a faculty in 2000, and right now she's working as a Director Professor, Department of Physiology, Maulana Azad Medical College. Her areas of focuses are autonomic nervous system, exercise physiology, and respiratory physiology. She has published a significant numbers of papers in foreign and in the Indian index journals. Her original review article, Role of Cardiovascular Reactivity to Mental Stress in Predicting Future Hypertension, it was published in Journal of Clinical and Experimental Hypertension, USA, has garnered worldwide appreciation from scientific community. And her work on role of adenoceptors in control of food intake has been a landmark research. She has received Rashtriya Ekta Puraskar for her contribution in teaching and research work. She has also authored a book, Practical Physiology, a Student's Workbook. She has also edited a renowned C.L. Bhai's textbook of Practical Physiology. Till date, she has guided a number of postgraduate students in their thesis work. Presently, she is involved in many research projects, including physiology of handwriting, and its role in the process of identification processes. She has chaired numerous scientific sessions in various conferences all over India, and she is an active member of many committees constituted by Delhi government. She is a favorite of her students, and as being favorite of the students, she continues to guide them through her role as director, professor, and head of department, physiology, MAMC. Thank you so much for joining us today, ma'am. Okay, so I welcome all of you once more, and without further delay, I request Dr. Ayan, our senior resident and coordinator for the SCIT category, to start with the competition. Dr. Ayan would take you through different landmarks of our institute, like our main college building, auditorium, our department, even our student cafeteria. The whole idea is that he will give us the idea of letting us feel that as if we are in the institute itself. Before I do that, I would request everyone to maximize their screens for YouTube streaming, because if we do so, then the comments, whoever is posting on YouTube, won't hinder our screen. So over to you, Dr. Ayan.
Thank you, Dr. Divya. A very warm welcome and good afternoon to one and all present over here, online and offline. Today is the first day of our All India Online Physiology Festival 2020, and today is the SCIT day. I am Dr. Ayan Goswami, the SCIT coordinator. First of all, I would like to thank our esteemed director, Dr. N.N. Mathur sir, head of the Department of Physiology, Dr. Sunita Mandal ma'am, Professor Dr. Madhulika Monga ma'am, and Professor Dr. Anita Power ma'am, for giving me the opportunity to be the SCIT coordinator. We are delighted and we are overwhelmed with the enthusiastic performance by the students all over India from different medical colleges. We have total 8 SCIT teams today, and we will stream their SCIT performances live on YouTube. Now, a reminder for our audience, please support and vote for your favorite SCIT team. The voting link is given in the description box below. Please click on the link and choose your favorite SCIT team. Now, without wasting any further time, I will start streaming of our first SCIT team, that is Kathua Combatants. This team is led by Kanish Gupta, and they are from Government Medical College, Kathua. So let's enjoy their performance.
Let's go. Give this man the push. Activate.
Yeah, but let's go get something to eat now first.
Oh my God. Huh. Chill after all, huh?
No. You have a lot on your memo today.
Not so chill after all then. But anyways, let's have a hungry feed. Let's feed the stomach. It's been rumbling since.
Fried food. It tastes good, and we have another option also, no? But the fat.
Thank you, Dr. Anita.
So I welcome all of you once more, and without further delay, I request Dr. Ayan.
Hey, we're having an office reunion tonight, so you want to join?
Yes, I'm all in. Oh my God, must be work fatigue, I guess.
Seems like you really need some rest. Just take a break from this hodgepodge.
Hey there.
Hey, come on in. Why the pale face, though?
Feel very well. I don't feel very, well.
What is happening? My blood supply. Now that I think of it, I've been devoid of my blood supply for quite a time now. And oh, it's aching. Yo, brain, what are you doing? Would you mind searching for the root of the problem? My muscles, they're not in the right mood, and oh my god, I'm unable to pump blood in this poor man's body.
Hey, don't you worry. I'm already on it. Hey, you there! What are you? What the hell are you doing in this person's coronary artery?
What do you mean, what I am doing here? I was born here, come on.
The ST segment is elevated and there's a huge peak in the T wave. This certainly is a case of myocardial infarction. There, it's a clot. We'll have to administer some streptokinase as soon as possible.
Hey, what are you doing here? Son of a plague?
What do you mean, huh? I was born here. It all started when my mother, cholesterol, fell in love with my dad, blood platelet, and they had me, the clot.
Why would I care anything about you, say? You dare enter here now? Face a death sentence.
This son of a plague. Nice presentation, team Katsuba Competence. Now the next team is Agents of Brain. This team is led by Karan Chandwani and they are from Jalwar Medical College, Jalwar, Rajasthan.
Camera rolling and action. Are where is our news anchor? Starting again. 3, 2, 1.
Hello, hi, welcome to Abhidhak News, live from superolateral city. Myself, Sainab Sharma, will guide you towards the breaking news of superolateral city located in our state brain, located in our marvelous country, the human body. A man named Mr. Broca Arora, resident of flat number 4445, parts opercularis and parts triangularis apartments in inferior frontal gyrus colony of our city, is on a major strike. Our ground reporter, Mr. Navjot Singh Niron, will provide you insights of what is happening there.
Bole Sonehal Sastri Akal. Namaste. Oji, myself Navjot Singh Niron ji, ground reporter of Abhitak News Channel from Superolateral City. You know my name, na? If you don't know, you can search my name on googly.com and send me a friend request on Facebook. Today we are standing on the site where Mr. Broca Arora is sitting on the strike. Let's find out why is he sitting on the strike. Let's have a word with him. Mr. Arora, why are you on strike, ji?
Well, you see, this greedy and mean MC corporation cut my blood supply without any reason. So tell me, what should I bring now?
Oji, what are your demands, ji?
See, like any other area, I also require 24/7 proper blood supply to fulfill my necessities.
Oji, if you remain on strike for such a long period, what losses will our country is going to encounter?
See, if I will be on the strike for a very long time, then our great country will be speechless. In technical terms, we can say the country will have motor fascia recession. In the long terms, this will affect the communication of our country with others and cost our country financially. Thus, our country will suffer.
This was Mr. Broca Arora, to whom we talked.
Dear viewers, you were listening to Mr. Broca Arora, who is on strike due to stoppage of their area's blood supply. Due to this same reason, Mr. Vandikesh Banerjee is also on strike. Mr. Vandikesh Banerjee is a resident of flat number 20-39 and 40 of Angular and Supramarginal Gyrus Colony of our city. Let's have a dip in the matter. Our ground reporter will take you up there.
I am back, ji. You, now you all are familiar with me, na? I am Mr. Navjot Singh, you are on the ground reporter of Abhi Tak News Channel. OG, you have sent me a friend request on Facebook or not? If not, open your mobile phone and send me the friend request on Facebook right now. OG, this back pain na is hurting me a lot today, ji. Actually, I am the only ground reporter with Abhi Tak News Channel and they gave me a lot of work, ji. And they don't give me a single holiday to take my baby to Canada to meet Parjai ji. Anyways, now let's have a word with Mr. Vanikesh Banerjee and see why is he sitting on strike. Mr. Banerjee is on strike even in this heavy rain. Oh ji, Mr. Banerjee Paji, why are you on strike ji?
Sir, I have the same issue as my neighbor Mr. Arora, that we both are not getting proper supplies from the MCA Corporation, who is the major blood supplier of our city.
Oh Paji, what are your demands?
My sole demand is that corporation should supply blood to each and every area fairly.
Oh Paji, what impact will our great country have due to this strike?
If this strike continues, then our country, the human body, will be unable to understand what other countries are speaking. International relations of our country will be broken with everyone. Medically speaking, they will be sensory aphasia slump, due to which proper exchange of words and sentences along with businesses of reading and writing will get hugely affected by it.
Oh ji, thank you Mr. Banerjee. I hope that your demands are fulfilled as early as possible ji.
According to the reports, the major supplier of our city, the MCA Corporation, has been filed for bankruptcy under the Human Body Act 1992. This type of bankruptcy has been infamously known as the MCA Stroke Scam 2020. So that's all for today's The Breaking Hour. Thank you for watching. Join us tomorrow at the same time only on Abhi Tak.
Again, it was a nice presentation by the team Agents of Brain. Now, I would like to remind our audience, please vote and support your favorite skit team. And the voting link for the audience is given in the description box below. Our next team is Team Legion and it is led by Avantika Devnath. This team is from All India Institute of Medical Science, Kalyani, West Bengal.
I am Thalamus. I start my action. Yes.
I am Globus Pyrrhus Internus. I inhibit Thalamus.
I am Globus Pyrrhus Externus. I inhibit Globus Pyrrhus Internus.
I am Stratum. I receive signal of Vortex and Substantia Nigra.
I am Substantia Nigra. My left hand sends dopamine to D1 receptors and my right hand sends dopamine to D2 receptors.
We have Cortex.
We send signal to striatum.
Start working, dear.
Say something, man.
After work.
Sorry bro, I did not get order to release you.
Presentation by the team Legion from AIIMS Kalyani, West Bengal. Now our next team is team ATP, that is Antics.Physiologics. This team is led by N. Sai Jyothi Swarup. This team is from Sri Venkateswara Medical College, Tirupati, Andhra Pradesh.
It is generally difficult to memorize some concepts without proper understanding. We can understand them by correlating these concepts with our day-to-day activities. This skit is a fictional story where God sends a gift to a boy to help him understand the things properly.
A gift from God.
Please, let me sleep. God?
Yeah, kid. Come on, wear your specs.
My child, I came to help you learn something new today. By the way, why your dad switched on the light?
He wants me to wake up.
I think it's one of the homemade techniques.
I named it DRS.
Dad's rule of waking up son.
Nothing like that, my child. It is actually the concept of the reticular activating system. The reticular activating system is stimulated by the visual pathway via collaterals as soon as the light is switched on. The fibers of the reticular activating system then project from the brainstem to the cortex and leads to arousal and thereby disturbing your sleep.
Wow, it sounds new.
Yeah, hi Swarup.
Hi Sam, how are you?
Yeah, I'm fine. Did you pay an exam fee?
No.
Oh, today's the last day you have to pay it in office.
Okay then, you are in the college, right? Will you pay it for me? I will send you the money.
Oh, sorry Swarup, I don't have a bank account.
Oh. Okay then, bye.
Yeah, okay, bye.
Hello. Hi Mohan, how are you?
I am fine.
Okay, I think you are in the college, right? I need your help. I will send you money. Will you please pay my exam fee?
Sure, send me money through bank. I will do it.
Okay, thank you. I will send you money. Bye.
Kid, how come your friend could pay your fee?
Yeah, actually I am unable to go to college, you know. So I took help of my friend who is already in the college. I will send him money and he will pay the fee.
So the way you couldn't pay the fee by yourself and asked your friend for help. Similarly, we have in our body the non-lipid soluble hormones. These cannot enter cell and thus require the help of a secondary messenger to carry out their actions. Few examples of such hormones are the luteinizing hormone and the follicle stimulating hormone.
Hi, Sunny.
Hey, hi. Actually, I need a help. I want to buy some products in Amazon. So, as you have Prime account,
okay.
Can I use your account?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, then I will place order. Tell me the OTP you received.
I will just send you the
article.
Don't worry. Okay.
Kid, why did she ask for your help?
God, as she enters the OTP I had sent to her, the app server will receive it as if I am sending the order. So, it does not matter who is actually sending it. It is always received as if it is sending from the account owner.
Good. Like is the so-called phantom limb. wherever maybe the stimulus is applied in a sensory pathway, it is always perceived as if it is coming from the receptor end. Due to this, in amputated limbs, the irritation of the cut nerve endings leads to the perception that it is coming from the receptors, which are not at all present.
There are many such things we can correlate like this. Knowledge is not about knowing, but it's also about learning.
So it was a very entertaining performance. Now our next team is Team Metabolic Masters. The team is led by Garima Som, and this team is from Maulana Azad Medical College, New Delhi. Let's enjoy.
A very good morning to all my colleagues present here. I am Medullary Interstitium and you can call me Madam M. I want to welcome you all to this new melanephric world. We are here to devise a plan to regulate body fluid volume. Also, the only stumbling block here is the glomerular filtration membrane, who refused to be biased during filtration. And one of our teammates, DCT, will not be here with us because he is engaged in some other meeting organized by the Juxta Glomerular Apparatus. So, we all should begin.
How can you even think of a meeting without calling me? The one whose deficiency will make you lose 20 to 25 liters of urine per day. And excess will make you so thirsty that you will not be able to make 300 to 400 ml per day. So don't you dare underestimate me.
Sir, to be very polite, this behavior is not expected here. So kindly take your seat and drink Sprite.
In our plan, I will be simply reabsorbing 70% of the filtrate load, reducing it to only 1/3 of the initial. And yes, now I think you can easily manage what is left of it. After all, I am not going to reabsorb everything.
Ascending limb, may I have your attention, please?
You have my attention. Ding, ding, ding.
We are always proud of you. But you reside in my brother cortex. That means you will produce isoosmotic fluid. We need to devise a plan to regulate what's left of your delicacy.
My love for you compels me to use my activine pumps. If you are at 300 milliosmo per liter concentration, I will raise it and create a horizontal concentration gradient of 200 between you and me. I just want to become part of your counter current multiplier. I am giving you 25% of solute from the filtrate that I receive. Tip of
1200 milliosmo per liter. So selfless, dear. Vasa Rita, I am flowing in an opposite direction. Despite of your sluggish flow. Take this.
Me? I know I work passively, but you can't call me sluggish. After all, I'm the only counter current exchanger you have. I have to accept this hypertonic fluid via my descending limb. But remember, I will not go beyond 1100 milliosmos per liter due to the lag phenomena.
Well, let me help you. But in return, I'll be a counter-current multiplier. I've got aquaporin 1 for 20% water reabsorption. But you guys want me to throw out the salts too? No, not happening. All I'm gonna do is let the water move out, but not the salts. Don't thank me. I know I'm not.
I apologize for overreacting earlier. Being a capillary, I'm equally permeable to both salt and water. Using this property and increased protein concentration, my ascending limb will extract water from you, Madam M, and increase my blood's volume and osmolarity, ultimately maintaining your concentration gradient.
So you save my osmolarity from getting dissipated.
Oh my god!
This filtrate osmolarity is so low, just 100 milliosmoles per liter. I should use my aquaporins 2 and 3 to reabsorb excess water. Also, Madam M, you will be highly impressed by the urea reabsorbed by my urea transporter A1. It will help you increase the osmolarity by 40-50%.
Yulia, I feel its complexity appealing.
What?
You're not home. I still love you, darling. Don't backbite boss kidney about me trafficking some of it, and I will promote you all. Ascending lamp. Can you secure some?
I'll ask for it soon. I secured your hand. Then why not this Yulia?
You think it's a piece of cake? What if I say that this human is not drinking enough? Then what?
To increase your water permeability, to decrease the hyperosmolarity of blood, to donate urea to medulla. ADH is here for you collecting dust. So guys, fasten your seatbelts, and especially you collecting dust. Because we will be using your special vesicles that have aquaponics. And urea transporter A3 to transport water and urea to Madam M. And that's how we roll.
I was desperately looking for you, my hero.
Yes, that's what I wanted. This plan seems so promising. Boss Kidney is going to promote me for sure.
You all, just keep an eye on Diuretic Private Limited. I shall conclude it here.
Next team is Physio Frontiers from Bhadnagar. This team is led by Astha and they are from GM ERS Medical College, Bhadnagar, Gujarat.
Hans Berger, the inventor of EEG electroencephalogram, which is the scoreboard of the sleep games. Now to start with, let us know the basic rules of the sleep games. First is the duration of the sleep game, which is approximately 6 hours. The game is divided into two types of sleeps, the NREM, that is non-rapid eye movement sleep, which further has 4 stages, stage 1, 2, 3 and 4, and REM, that is rapid eye movement sleep. The sleep cycle begins from when you are awake, when your eyes are open, then eyes closed. Then comes stage 1, 2, 3, 4 of NREM, then comes stage 3, 2 REM. So this cycle of stage 2, 3, 4, 3, 2 REM takes approximately 90 minutes. It gets repeated after 90 minutes and the REM comprises approximately 25% of the total sleep in an average adult and the rest is comprised by the NREM.
Why God, why? Why am I not able to sleep these days? What should I do? Might be reading something may fall me asleep. Let's see. What? It's already 6 in the morning? I spent my whole night only reading this and I didn't fall asleep? I have to do something.
Hi, I am Inspector Sleep Sata. To bring back Pinky Nindwali to sleep at any cost. Jai Hind.
Whoa. Wait, I am the boss here and I'll get to decide whether she'll get asleep or not. Try your best.
Hi, I am REM sleep, that is rapid eye movement sleep. I comprise approximately 25% of the total sleep in an average adult such as Mrs. Pinky Nindwan. Also, I am characterized by two types of waves basically on the EEG. One type of waves are the low amplitude, high frequency waves which resemble the beta waves which are seen in aroused or awake state. That is why I am also known as paradoxical sleep. Other types of waves are known as PGO spikes which are sudden electrical outbursts from the pons, which then goes to the lateral geniculate body, that is the LGB, and finally reaches the occipital cortex, hence the name PGO. I am relatively uninterrupted because I have high threshold for awakening. Also, I may experience sometimes spontaneous awakening. Sometimes you may find me drooped over you if you are sitting next to me on a bus ride because there is loss of neck muscle tone during me. Also, you can have vivid dreams when you're experiencing me, which are known as nightmares, because these are dreams which you can remember, unlike those which are known as night terrors and found in that NREM which you cannot even remember. Okay, I'll see you next after 90 minutes of my cycle. Have a good night's sleep till then.
Hi, I'm NREM sleep, and I am a very restful man. My heart rate, blood pressure, and respiratory rate are so low, along with my body metabolism. But I love to dream. But I always forget. You can produce me by eliciting my 3 sleep zones. Also, I have 4 stages.
Hi, I am stage 1 and I consist of low voltage mixed frequency patterns. I have theta rhythm. My frequency is 4 to 7 hertz. I am stage 2 and I occupy 45% of NREM sleep. I consist of sinusoidal waves which are sleep spindles. My frequency is 7 to 15 hertz. I consist of K complex. I am stage 3 and I consist of low frequency high amplitude delta waves. My frequency is 0.5 to 4 hertz. Stage 4. I consist of least frequencies and large waves with maximum slowing.
So this brings us to the end of the sleep games. And here is our final scoreboard. Stage 1 is showing normal theta waves. Stage 2 is showing sleep spindles and K complexes. Stage 3 and stage 4 can be seen having delta waves. And REM sleep is showing high frequency, low amplitude waves along with PGO spikes. So what do you think? Who is the winner? Yes, so in this game, the honest inspector Sleep Sartaj wins the game.
So it was a nice presentation. Again, I will remind the audience, please vote for your favorite speed team. And the link for voting is given in the description box below. Now, the next team is Team Covians. This team is led by Bhavna. And they are from Government Medical College, Pali, Rajasthan.
Hello, myself ATP, the energy bank.
Myosin.
I will hydrolyze myself for an activation into ADP and inorganic phosphate.
Oh ATP, please come inside. I am ready to hydrolyze you.
Myosin.
Oh, you get hydrolyzed and I get activated.
I get hydrolyzed.
I am action potential. Without me, the wave of depolarization to the T-tubular system will not generate. As the wave is generated, the DSPR is activated.
Me and my friend Rhinodine have mechanical coupling.
I am Rhinodine receptor. I will open and help in flooding of calcium from sarcoplasm.
Hello, I am Calcium Ion. I live in sarcoplasmic reticulum.
I am another Calcium Ion from sarcoplasmic reticulum.
Yay! Finally we are out!
No calcium. You are wrong. I am nifedipine, a calcium channel blocker. I will not let you out from the sarcoplasmic reticulum.
Hush, it was just a dream. Nifedipine is absent. I can get out of the sarcoplasmic reticulum.
So, nifedipine can stop the calcium ions by blocking DHPR receptors. It has a clinical point here. It lowers the blood pressure by relaxing the blood vessels so that blood flow more easily. It can be given in the pain of angina or stroke.
Myself, troponin tropomyosin complex. I hide the myosin binding site on actin. Come calcium, I am a special site for you TNC subunit.
Yes, I will help you to unmask the active site of actin.
Yay! Now we can initiate muscle contraction.
Thus, the cross bridge breaks and the cycle repeats.
Now the last participant team in today's speech competition is Team Transmission Musketeers. This team is from Lady Hardinge Medical College, New Delhi.
Let me see who is sitting opposite to me. Hey, UEC pouch.
Hey, what are you saying?
Look who is messing with me. The emotional fool having his emotion high all the time with little runny nose. Ew.
You don't dare talk about my emotions. When I will come to show my anger, you all will be left with pin rolling your fingers and become rigid like a pipe.
I have never expected this kind of behavior from you.
What are you guys saying? Please keep your sodium and calcium channels shut and let's start with the interview. I want you all to have a look at this video.
You know what? I'm going on a date with Mr. Daniel Radcliffe. And the most exciting thing is, he personally called me to go on a date with him.
What? Hello, hello, anybody? What is this girl saying? This is so delusional.
We are here, Mr. Host. Actually, our Mr. Dopes likes this girl and wanted to have a grand entry with her. So, and also because we are known for our mischievous behavior and our high activism, so...
Let me tell him further, Nora. We added some amphetamine in her alcohol and it causes an immense rush of dopamine and noradrenaline.
Oh, you are dopamine, Mr. Dopes. Don't act like you have Alzheimer's disease.
Yeah. Actually, me and Nora together overdraw her D2 receptors in the limbic system, which raises overwhelmed throats.
How cruel you are. Phew.
Help. My NMDA receptors aren't working.
No, honey, ignore it. I'm all yours. We'll work together in the brain, okay?
Huh. Here starts their so-called fairy tale. Hashtag honey bunny.
Can you please be quiet, Miss Sarah? Or I will activate my pain pathway to get you out of your sleep.
No, as if I care.
Shut up, all of you. Please stop it.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Gaps. Okay, so now we have a next video. Happened to her? Is she okay? Sarah and Nora has been mischievous always and being diminished leading to all this.
I know the reason why we are being accused, Nora. The drugs that block our secretion like Rezurock frequently cause depression. And because we normally provide a drive to the limbic system of the brain to increase the sense of well-being and happiness, good appetite, psychomotor balance. Although too much of anything can also cause mania.
Oh, that was so informative, Miss Sarah. Thank you.
Did anybody notice my aminobutyric pants? I bought it from glutamate decarboxylase.
People are so annoying.
Nobody cares. Am I right, Mr. Andy?
I would rather prefer to eat a burger than advertising my pants. So.
By the way, sorry for the interruption, audience. Now I would like to show you all a video where a mother is pointing towards her daughter.
You, hey girl, why are you opening my refrigerator? Who are you? Are you there to steal my sausages? I have two daughters, Laura and Lisa, and their pictures are kept in my drawer. Oh, I'm sorry, honey. I'm sorry. Come.
Who is the culprit here?
Sir, I know, sir. The girl stealing the sausages.
Oh, please, Mr. Gabs, don't act layman.
Hello, Mr. Host. Myself, Chief Ashley, and I'm the visitor in this case. Actually, this is due to the degeneration of my crown, known as cholinergic neuron.
Oh, really, sir? Me being his neighbor in the brain has a responsibility to keep an eye on what is happening at his home, and what I see is his wife took all his cholinergic neurons labeled crown and threw him out of his house, and as he is one of an elite amongst the transmitters, he cannot enter without that crown into the hippocampus and neocortex to perform his memory and learning function. Am I right?
Actually, yes. He's right, and the story ends with this lady having Alzheimer's disease with dementia, psychosis, difficulty in learning, confusions, delusions, and paranoia.
Oh my god, so sorry to hear this.
Yeah, make cholinesterase inhibitors like Aricept have mercy on her.
Yes, thank you all for doing this time from your hectic schedule of impulse transmission. Rest, and can't tolerate any of you anymore. I'm rushing for a fresh bout of air. Bye-bye.
Okay, so nice presentation team, Transmission Musketeers from Lady Hyderabad Medical College, New Delhi. Transmission Musketeers is our last team, that is the 8th team. Now we are at the end of our skit competition. Again, I will remind our audience, please vote for your favorite skit team. The link for voting is given in the description box below. The voting line will remain activated up to half an hour after the end of today's session. Now, I would like to thank everyone for watching the live streaming of All India Online Physiology Festival 2020, day one, that is the skit day. Now, for the further proceeding of our festival, I will hand over to Dr. Divya.
Thank you, sir, for coordinating such a wonderful event. The students have given so many creative ideas. I also have learned many things from them. Congrats to each and every team, each and every individual who has participated here. You all have given your excellent work. Now I request Dr. Tanmay Talukdar, Head of Department of Tuberculosis and Respiratory Medicine, Lady Harding Medical College, to say a few words. Sir, please.
Yeah, good afternoon, everybody. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. You know what? I am speechless. Two reasons. One, I was not very sure whether I was seeing medical students here because... See, hello. Yeah. So most of you use technology to such an extent that I was not very sure ki hum medical students dekh rahe hain ki whether we had early cinematography students presenting their skills and wares. So that is my first point. Second point is a big congrats to Department of Physiology, because this is such a new concept. I mean, bringing such technology into teaching, we are aware of it theoretically, but this has been done. I mean, you did it. Congratulations to the entire team, Dr. Madhulika Monga, Dr. Pawar, and obviously Sunita Madam and the entire team. A big congratulations to all of you. And finally, the pressure you all have put on us, the teachers. The way, I mean, I have been part of medical education of Lady Harding, and we have all been striving that we should do role plays, we should do drama, we should make it fun. But what you did today is using technology, drama, role play, mingling it with the concept. And I mean, it's very well done. I mean, you make learning so much fun, and you put so much pressure. You have put so much pressure on all us teachers to make our teaching out of that boring, monotonous lecture and make it more colorful and probably use technology much more than what we do now. Once again, a big congratulations to all of you for almost being on time and making such a wonderful presentation. Thank you so much, and over to the compere.
Unmute yourself, Divya.
Sorry. A special thanks to you, sir, for taking part in this festival, and thanks, sir, for such a wonderful comment. I request Dr. Moni Bailey, Director of Professor in Physiology Department, Maulana Azad Medical College, to say a few words. Ma'am, please.
I'm also speechless. I mean, the way you people act, your concepts, everything is far beyond your age. You people really, really, you know, set a very high standard, and you know, for us also as teachers, and it was super exciting and super fun. And I'm speechless. It was wonderful. The concepts and everything were very clear and nice. And you know, you were so young, and then this age, when you are doing such a beautiful job of this, I think you'll go a far way ahead in your life. All the best to you guys. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Special thanks to you, ma'am, for taking part in this festival. I request Dr. Manvi Singh Mathu, postgraduate student in the Department of Physiology, Lady Harding Medical College, to give a vote of thanks.
Please unmute yourself.
Thank you for being with us. I, Dr. Manvi Singh Mathu, deem it a great honor and privilege to propose the vote of thanks on this memorable occasion. Now, we come to the end of day one skit presentation of Physiology Festival. Prior to winding it up, a few words of announcements and warmth to all of you. We hope you all have a very good evening. On behalf of the organizing committee, let me first of all start by giving glory to the God for making today's event a resounding success. First and foremost, I thank our judges, Dr. Mona Bedi, Director Professor Physiology, MMC, and Dr. Tanmay Talukdar, HOD TV Chest, LHMC, who despite their busy schedule have found time to grace this occasion. I thank our esteemed director, LHMC, Dr. N.N. Mathur, for his unstinted support for the festival. No event can take shape without a hardworking leader and organizer, chairpersons. My heartfelt thanks to organizing chairperson, the head of physiology department, Dr. Sunita Mondal, for her valuable contribution, guidance, and encouragement in all our efforts. Above and beyond the backbone of this festival, our organizing secretary, Dr. Madhulika Monga, Professor Physiology, LHMC, and joint organizing secretary, Dr. Anita Pawar, Professor Physiology, LHMC, who went extra mile for making this dream a reality. I owe special gratitude to all organizers, coordinators, who worked very hard to ensure that this occasion becomes a memorable success. I thank all the distinguished invitees and participants for accepting our invitation. I also thank all the audience for your interest and attention. Last but not the least, I thank all my colleagues for your cooperation in making this event a resounding success. Thank you, everyone. And please don't forget to join us tomorrow for poetry event. Thank you.